Hey everyone,
welcome back to the series of Mastering Digital Logic Design with Logisim. Today we are diving into combinational circuits, the foundation of many digital systems. We will break down the combinational circuits R and then look at three specific examples: multiplexers, decoders and adders. By the end of this tutorial, you will not only understand the theory behind these circuits but also know how to design and simulate them using Logisim. So let's jump right in. Combinational circuits are digital circuits where the outputs depend only on the current inputs with no memory of previous states. Some classic example includes multiplexers, decoders and adders. These circuits are essential in computing system as they enable basic operation like selection, encoding and arithmetic. Let's begin with the multiplexer, or MUX for short. A MUX selects one of the several inputs, signals, and forwards the selected input to a single output. Think of it as a digital switch that routes one of the several inputs to a single output. For this tutorial, we will build a 4x1 MUX in Logisim. In 4x1 MUX, you have 4 data inputs line, 2 control line, and 1 output line. The control line determines which inputs get forward to the output. Let's go to the Logisim and design our MUX. To design MUX, go to the Plexer tab, drag the multiplexer and place it to a canvas. Here you can see by default the MUX we have got is of 2x1. As we have said, we are designing a 4x1 MUX, so we have to select the MUX, go to its properties tab and change its select bit from 1 to 2. This will make our MUX to 4x1. As in this tutorial, we are not going to look how the enable pin works, so let's just switch it off. As we have our MUX here, so now let's connect the 4 input pins to the inputs of the MUX. The first input will be known as D0, the second input will be known as D1, the third input will be known as D2. The fourth input will be known as D3. Now connect the input pin to the select line as well. Here you can see as soon as we connect our input pin to the select lines, it shows our error to incompatible bits. It is because the select line is of 2 bits and the input we have connected is of single bit. So to remove this error, we have to change our input bit to 2 bits as well. So click on the input pin, go to its properties tab and change its data bit from 1 to 2. Now you can see the error has been removed. Now let's connect the output pin to the MUX so we can see which result are getting routed to the output. Before we simulate this multiplexer design in Logisim, let's review the truth table. The 4x1 MUX has 4 data inputs, as we mentioned, I0, I1, I2, I3, or either D0, D1, D2 and D3, and 2 select lines which are S0 and S1. The select line determines which input is passed to the output. When both of S0 and S1 are 0, the first input, which is I0, is passed to the output. When S0 is 0 and S1 is 1, the second input, I1, is passed to the output. When S0 is 1, S1 is 0, the third input, I2, is passed to the output. When both S0 and S1 are 1, the fourth input, I3, is passed to the output. In short, the combination of S0 and S1 directly controls which input is routed to the output, as shown in the truth table. Now let's simulate the circuit. Before we start applying the combinations, let's have some values to the input pin so that we can see is the our multiplexer design is working correctly or not. To simulate this 4x1 MUX design, I will going to toggle the select lines S0 and S1 to determine how the input is selected. As you can see, when both S0 and S1 are 0, the first input, which is D0, is passed to the output. If we change this S0 to 1, While still the S1 still remains 0, you can see the second input is routed to the output. Now let's toggle S1 and make toggle S0 to 0. Here you can see the third input is routed to the output. When both select lines are high, you can see the fourth input is toggled to the output. To make sure, let's toggle the input so we can see that exactly the fourth input is getting routed to the output. So as we toggle through the different combinations of S0 and S1, you will see how the corresponding input is routed to the output in real time. Multiplexers are used in scenarios where data from multiple sources need to be selected and routed. For instance, they play a vital role in data routing and can even be a part of more complex systems like ALU. Next, let's look at the decoder. A decoder takes n input lines and generates up to 2 power n output lines, which only one active input output at any time. It's used when we need to activate a specific output line from multiple outputs. To build a 2x4 decoder in Logisim, we have to drag the decoder from Plexus tab and place it in our canvas. Here you can see by default the decoder is of 1x2. So we have to change it to 2x4. So select the decoder, move to the properties tab, and select bits from 1 to 2. As I've mentioned earlier that we are not going to see how the enable pin works here, so let's just disable it. Now let's connect the input signal to the decoder and connect 4 output pin to the outputs of the decoder. This is output 1, which will be going to connect to the first output pin of decoder. Second output will be connected to the second output of decoder. Third pin will be connected to the third output. And fourth pin will be connected to the fourth output. Before we simulate this design, let's look at the truth table. The 2x4 decoder takes 2 input lines, which are A0 and A1. And generate 4 outputs. Only one of the output is active at any given time based on the binary combination of the input lines. When I0 and A0 and A1 both are 0, the first output D0 is active. When A0 is 0, A1 is 1, the second output D1 is active. When A0 is 1, A1 is 0, the third output D2 is active. When both A0 and A1 are 1, the fourth output D3 is active. The truth table shows the binary encoding of the inputs and their corresponding output activation. Now let's simulate the circuit. In the simulation, we will toggle the input switch A0 and A1 to show how active output changes. When both are set to 0, the first output is activated. Changing A0 to 1 will activate the second output of the decoder. If we toggle the A1 pin and switch it back, toggle the A0 as well, you can see the third output is activated. When both the select lines is 1, you can see the fourth output is activated. As we change the binary values on the input lines, you can see how only one output line is active at a time, demonstrating the decoding function. Decoders are commonly used in system for tasks like memory addressing and instruction decoding in CPUs. For instance, a decoder can help activate one specific memory location out of many. Finally, let's discuss adders, which are fundamental components of arithmetic logic units, ALUs. Adders perform basic arithmetic operations like addition. We will focus on two types today, the half adder and the full adder. a half adder at two single bit numbers and produce a sum and a carry as output. Let's move towards the Logisim and design our adder. To design an adder, we have to select a XOR gate and AND gate. Now add two input pins for a single bit numbers. We will consider this input pin as A and we will consider the second input pin as B, connecting the same input A to the input pin of the AND gate and B to the second input of the AND gate. Let's also connect the output pin to both the gates. The XOR gate will calculate the sum and the AND gate will calculate the carry. Let's review the truth table before we simulate the design. The half adder add two single bits input, which is A and B, and produce two outputs, sum and carry. When both A and B are 0, the sum is 0 and the carry is also 0. When A is 0 and B is 1, the sum is 1 and the carry is 0. When A is 1 and B is 0, the sum is 1 and the carry still remains 0. When both A and B are 1, the sum is 0 but carry is 1, indicating that the sum exceeds in 1 in binary. Now let's simulate the design. In the half adder simulation, we will toggle inputs A and B to demonstrate how the sum and carry output changes. When both inputs are 0, there is no sum or carry. Both outputs are 0. When either A or B is set to 1, the sum output becomes 1 but the carry still remains 0. When if both inputs are set to 1, the sum output will remain 0 and the carry output will be 1, indicating that we have exceeding the single bit capacity. As you can see, half adder handles binary addition, producing both a sum and a carry when needed. Let's move on our full adder design. A full adder takes three inputs, two single bit numbers and a carry in from the previous bit. So let's move to the design, the full adder. To design a full adder, we are going to use two XOR gate. Two AND gate and one OR gate. Let's select two input pins, which will be considered as A and B. Here you can see our input A and B first go towards the first XOR gate and the output of the XOR gate is connected to the second XOR gate with input C in. So let's build this circuit first to generate the result of sum. Connecting A to the first input of the XOR gate, connecting B to the second input of the XOR gate. The output of the XOR gate will be connected to the second input and the third pin will act as C, which will be connected to the output of the second XOR gate will going to produce us a sum. So let's connect an output pin. Now let's see how we have to design the carry out design. Here you can see the first AND gate having an input from a C in and the output of the first OR gate. The second AND gate consists of AND operation of A and B. The result of both AND gates getting OR, and from that we are getting a Cout signal. So let's connect the input pins to the design. A, connecting A and connecting B, connecting C. And the first output connecting push. Okay, now again connect the one output pin to the OR gate so we can see the output of C out. Okay, we are done with our circuit designing. Let's review the truth table before we simulate the design. The full adder is similar to the half adder but takes into account a third input, which is carry in. This is allow it to add two single bits number along with a carry from a previous calculation. When all inputs A, B, C in are 0, both sum and output are 0. When A and B both are 0 but C in is 1, the sum is 1 and the carry is 0. When A is 1 and both B and C are 0, the sum is 1 and carry is 0. When all 3 inputs are 1, the sum is 1 and the carry is also 1. Let's simulate the design and see it's working. In full adder simulation, we will toggle the inputs A, B and C in to show how the sum and carry outputs change depending on the combination. When all the inputs are set to 0, you can see both outputs are 0. When either A, B or C in is set to 1, but not all, the sum becomes 1 and carry remains 0. When all of the inputs are set to 1, the sum becomes 1 and the carry is also 1, showing the carry propagation, how the carry propagation works. The full adder is essential for adding multiple bit numbers because it handles carry propagation from one bit to the next. Adders are integral to CPUs and other digital arithmetic systems. In an ALU, they perform not only addition but also more complex functions like subtraction and multiplication when combined with other circuits. That wraps up our session on combinational circuits. Today we have covered multiplexers, decoders and adders, all of which are essential building blocks for more complex digital systems like CPUs and ALUs. What next? In the next video, we will explore sequential circuits, circuits that involve memory and state. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you won't miss it. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.